And so today I am doing a tutorial of a step-by-step, hopefully good enough, step-by-step video of to do wing liner. Wing liner is really hard. I'm going to do two different kinds of wing liners. One that's more Ariana Grande inspired to me personally, and then two Adele. What inspired this video was the Instagram photo of Adele's eyeliner saying everyone's waiting for Adele to drop an eyeliner tutorial. And so I was like, I need to do an eyeliner tutorial. People have asked me, I always get questions, how do you perfect your eyeliner? And it's honestly lots and lots and lots of patience. Basically learning, practice does make perfect. Even still though, till this day, I make mistakes. In the video, you'll see a close up, you'll see all the black around my eyes, like from makeup remover, and you have to be patient with it. That's why I don't wear it every day. I used to wear it every day, but sometimes I just have an off day to where I'm like, I just say screw it and I remove it all and just wear no eyeliner on my lids and just mascara. So I'm hoping this tutorial will be helpful for some of you who's been wanting to do wing liner, but were too scared to. And all the other information will be in the rest of the video. But if you would like some help on learning how to do wing liner, please continue to watch this video. The essentials you're going to need is an angled brush that is very, very thin. You want to be as precise as possible. And this is for beginners, like you're wanting to get that perfect accomplished wing liner like Adele. Choose your darkest black and make sure you have a mirror too. So I got 2-in-1. This is the Anastasia Shadow Contour World Traveler Palette, and Noir is a really, really good black. So I'm going to need that. You're going to need your mascara for afterwards. Make sure you have cotton swabs with you, and I did a big boo-boo and did my foundation before I even realized I was going to do this tutorial. So I would say do your foundation, concealer, and everything last, because you're going to be using this and whatever makeup remover your choice. Make sure it's not much of an oil-based. That's why I'm using the Simple Micellar Water, because it won't be oily and I can keep applying eyeliner without any problem. And cotton swabs. You can get these anywhere, but you're going to need them to fix any boo-boo. So I would save your foundation and stuff for last. A liquid liner of your choice. These are my top two, Kat Von D's Trooper and then L'Oreal Super Slim Infallible Eyeliner. And I'm probably going to be using the Infallible and these both like mixed together just to help me achieve that wing liner. The L'Oreal is a felt tip. The applicators also can depend on like if it's easier to apply and stuff. This just comes out effortlessly. I have to work a little bit more with the Kat Von D. The Kat Von D isn't as black as L'Oreal, so if you're wanting a black liquid liner, I suggest the L'Oreal one. And then to finish off this Adele look, you're going to need a red lipstick. This is the only liquid red lipstick I have right now, which is Outlaw from Kat Von D. It is well loved and used because it's kind of rubbing off. But yeah, and after that, you just want to contour the shit out of your face because she's got the perfect contours in her face. So let's get started. So I'm just going to say there are many, many different kinds of winged liner. My wing liner is different every day. So it's going to differ. It's probably not going to look exactly like mine. Just work with the eye shape that you have. I love my eye shapes because I can do so many different kinds of wing liner, but I do hate them because I actually have two different shaped eyes in a certain way. That's why I do this eyeliner first, and then I usually have to try and compare this, which is one thing. You want your eyeliner to be as symmetrical as possible. I know that sounds weird, but it's gonna, if you're OCD like me, it's going to bug you, the hell out of you for the rest of the day if you don't get these as close as possible to being similar. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to be taking my little angled brush. This is eeny bitty, teeny tiny, very thin. And I'm going to be taking that noir I showed y'all earlier. And I'm just going to draw an outline on my eye, basically. And I'm going to try and be able to show every single step I do. If my hand gets in the way, I'm extremely sorry. Or if this gets in the way, I'm extremely sorry. So let's go. Get close to the lash line as possible, especially when going towards your inner tear duct. You do not want a thick line in your inner tear duct. Trust me. You want it to gradually begin to get bare as you go towards the outer of your eye. So we're going to start beginning that outer wing, and this is like very much pressure for a makeup artist. Like when I do this on clients, this is so much pressure. Some people say start at the very end of your eye, which would mine will be right here, but sometimes I do a little bit out, a little bit higher. I don't know. I break the rules. How about that? I have taken makeup artistry classes, and she's like, well, if you just start at the very outer point of your eye, it's always going to be similar for both eyes. And I'm like, no, because I have two different shaped eyes. So you can Amy Winehouse this shit and like go straight up like this. I like to go a little bit outwards like this. So there's that. I know it does not look that good, but trust me, you'll fix it. I'm going to curve it a little bit like that. Just follow me here. We will get this. Trust me. That's why you want the makeup remover. You're going to make boo-boos. And now connect it. Not all the way to the tip, but like halfway. And look what you're doing. You're doing that. Nice cat line. So as you can see, this is not perfect. I do not like the tip. So, and don't put anything on it. I'm not going to put anything on it. I'm going to see what it does. I'm just going to get a clean Q-tip. And I'm just going to press it on there. And then, just like, what's it called? Like, just do that. Just going to twist. And there you go. There you go. And then I'm just going to slightly wipe this away. Okay. Okay, let's do this. You can do this. Come on. Take the eyeliner pencil. I'm sorry, brush. And keep working to where you like it. Which I think that's about good enough right there. Now I'm going to work on the lid portion of the eye. I'm going to thicken this up right here. Gonna thicken that up. I usually like it to be slightly rounder on my eyelid, just to give shape to my eyelid for sure. Just fix that up a little bit too. I have to, like I said, connect it a little bit to my actual end of my eye. Okay, so that does not look bad. So now let's go over it with liquid liner. So that's pretty much how it looks like when I close my eyes. Then when you open them, it looks even prettier. So now let's go over it with your eyeliner of your choosing, liquid, or you can do gel. Gel, I think, was helpful when learning to do the cat eye. It's just slightly harder to clean up than liquid. But either way, you do what you do and do what you're comfortable with. You can even do this with pencil if you want to. Just make sure that your pencil is always sharpened, and when it starts to dull, sharpen it again, because you're going to want to want that point to make that really good tip. Or make sure you have, like I said, tons of Q-tips to help you just correct any mistakes. So, let's... I'm going to... Alright, I'm trying to go as slow as possible for you guys. I'm not touching the wing yet because the wing is most important. Okay, so I've lined my eye. As you can see, liquid liner makes a huge difference in statement-wise. So let's go. Take your time. The reason I'm going like really fast is because I'm more used to it now, I guess you could say. And if you think it's not giving you your product, just put it on the back of your hand and like, there you go. So this looks a little bit more Ariana Grande-ish than it does Adele, just because I give that little dent right there, just because it gives your eye a little bit more shape and dimension. Like I said, it looks a little bit more Ariana Grande-ish in a way because of how it looks. If I were to do thicken it up and just fill in that little dent right here, and like, even though it looks connected completely, if I were to just completely fill that in, it would definitely be more Adele, and I'll probably do that towards the end of the video and just show you what I'm talking about. Just basically thickening up that line and making it more sharp and straight. But right now we're doing a little bit more Ariana Grande. So now I'm going to do this side and then we'll get to doing the Adele part. I want to show you guys this real quick. This is a totally different eyeliner as I was trying to copycat this one. As you can see, they are two completely different looking eyes. Like, do you see the different effects that it gives doing different eyeliner? Okay, it's even. It may not look even on camera, but no matter how I angle on camera, it's not going to look even, but it is even to my eye shape. How about that? Okay, so this is basically Ariana Grande right here. Curved when you close your eyes. It's that nice, even slope. So let's turn this in to a little bit of Adele here. There we go. That is more Adele. That sharper, more edged out eyeliner. As you can see, you're going to make tons of mistakes and boo-boos, so you're going to want to do this before your foundation. So, do you see the difference? Ariana Grande, Adele. Ariana Grande, Adele. Okay, so this is the last and final version, the Adele version. It's just, I'm horrible at words, but to me it's more sharper and more triangle-esque. I don't know. The Ariana version is more rounded towards the cheekbones, is rounder. The Adele one is just cut. Like, it's sharp as a knife, as some would say. For the finishing Adele look, I was going to use, as you know, Outlaw from Kat Von D, and I did use that, but I went over it with the Marc Jacobs lipstick in So Rouge, which is only available for VIB Rouge people, I am sorry. Yeah, I hope this tutorial helped out some of you who's been wanting to do cat eyes, or the reason this video was inspired, you know, from the beginning, people were wanting Adele to come out with, like, a makeup tutorial on how she does her eyeliner. I'm not sure if Adele does her own makeup or if she has a makeup artist. I would believe she has a makeup artist. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this eyeliner tutorial. Please comment below any more suggestions that you would like to see sooner or later. And subscribe for more videos, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.